Welcome back to our series on ADAS calibrations. My name is Joe Keene. Today we're going to be doing a calibration on the front MILLIWAVE radar system on a 2017 RAV4. You'll also hear it called the PCS system, the pre-collision system that Toyota uses that are similar to a lot of other programs out there or systems that you've seen on the road, maintaining that distance from the car in front of you, and there's a radar that's going to be kind of keeping track of that. Again, anytime anything has happened with these vehicles, whether it be an accident, bumper removal, repainting, or any other reason that may have caused the radar to get a little bit out of skew, you always want to calibrate it. This one did have the front bumper removed. Nothing was actually damaged with the radar, but you know what? We're going to be on the safe side, and we're going to go ahead and check that calibration on this vehicle to make sure that the customer is safe. Stay tuned. We'll show you how this is done. Show some tools today that you have not used or seen in any of these videos. The first thing that we're going to want to do is hook up to our ADAS link with our VCI. So let's go ahead and hook that up and see what's going on. All right, on the bottom of the screen here we have ADAS calibration. That's what we're going to go ahead and select. We do have some options here. Front facing camera. This does have lane assist, so there is a camera in that windshield on this Toyota, but we are dealing with the front-facing radar, and that's the one we're going to select. All right, millimeter wave radar sensor adjustment is selected, is highlighted right here. We'll select that. Continue on with our... We do have an OEM warning that came through. A Toyota tech tip says, by design, certain Toyota vehicles require an ignition cycle. Off and on between diagnostic functions to operate properly. If you experience no communication during a diagnostic procedure, be sure to try an ignition cycle before moving on. It's a nice little tech tip to know, and that's a great thing that the Hunter and the ADASLink provide you with as a tech. All right, so... Right now on the screen, it just told us the required equipment for this one. The SCT-815 radar stand, a green line laser, a corner reflector, which will be attached to our radar stand, a black distance laser holder, and the red distance laser. We have a lot of this stuff right here. We'll get some close-ups, and I'm sure you'll get to see this in action as we go through. You'll also notice that we're not going to be using this stand at this time. So we've seen a couple where we use the stand with a large reflector. We did another video where you saw us only using the ADASLink, and that was our dynamic calibration on our Ford windshield. Now you're going to see another dynamic calibration, but with a different piece of equipment that does come with our DAS 3000. So we're going to go ahead and walk through this process. Again, just like every other video that we've done, Hunter has laid it out very nicely for you. I've said it once, I'll say it again, RFS. Read the friendly screen, really walks you through it, and you'll see just how easy this can be. Also tells you right here, mechanical vertical alignment of the sensor must be within OEM specifications before performing this calibration. Now remember I had said earlier, the actual bumper was removed. They did not see any physical damage to the radar, toward the mounting bracket itself, and everything did appear okay. They even did go ahead and check it with a laser level to see that it looked like it was in specifications. But again, we still want to verify that and make sure that it actually is in specifications. The sensor cannot recognize a vehicle ahead is another reason we may want to calibrate it, but you might have some other further diagnostics in that one. Our required preconditions on a level surface, this is where we've done all of our other previous ADAS calibrations, and I know this surface is level. Vehicle must be aligned, correct tires, and recommended pressure. I've already taken care of all of those steps, so we're not going to have to see those on screen right now. Front of the vehicle is free of metal. Make sure there's no damage to the front of the vehicle. Make sure there's no damage to the front bumper or grill. All of that has been repaired. Now clean the front emblem. Right behind the front emblem is where the radar sits, which most people don't know. So they actually want that surface clean and free of any debris or anything like that before you do the calibration that could throw it off a little bit. Remove all excess weight from the vehicle as well. Again, make sure there's nothing heavy in there that's causing any type of sag on the vehicle that could cause the sensor to maybe be pointing in an off direction. We are going to do the guided tour summary, again, to walk through all of the steps. All right, positioning radar stand 1 of 5. This is our front beam axis adjustment. We're going to place the radar reflector stand in front of the vehicle and attach the corner reflector. We're going to hang the black laser level holder on the corner reflector and place the distance laser in the horizontal position. And then point distance laser to the center of the license plate or front bumper. Adjust the height of the side-to-side position of the reflector stand to achieve distance laser position. So what we're going to go ahead and get out now is our laser stand. And you'll see I've taken a couple steps and already reattached our corner reflector. This is the component that they're talking about we're going to use on the stand. The other thing that we're going to need and that's going to slide over that. We're going to use that. And we also have a distance laser that is included with our kit that we're going to be using to measure the distance from here to the front of the vehicle. So I'm going to set that in here right now. We are going to press continue at this point. So now there is some specifications here that we're going to be doing. So place the green alignment laser in the vertical centering position located on top of the stand adapter plate. This is what they're talking about, is the green laser level. And we're going to want to set this right up on top of here, and that's what we're going to do now. So that's what it wants us to do. Now pay attention, there are some locating tabs here so that you can get that set up correctly, make sure it's centered in there, not rocking back and forth. Also telling us now to open up the rear hatch of the vehicle. So we're going to go ahead and open up the rear hatch. It'll make sense in just a second why we're actually going to do that. But we're going to go ahead and open up this rear hatch and start positioning our laser stand in front of the vehicle where it needs to be. You know, the nice thing about the ADASLink system is this docking station, but also the portability is what I really need sometime. I'm going to be a little bit farther away from the vehicle. So I'm going to take this with me over to where our laser stand is and start getting our distances. It's going to be a little bit easier to carry the tablet, keep it portable this way. So we'll head on over there and start getting our distances that are required that they're asking for on our system right now. So we're back in front of the vehicle here. I've got our stand set up roughly around 3,000. That's because I've done a few of these and I kind of know the distance a little bit. Saves us a little time as well. We will verify that with the distance laser that we have mounted on the front. We'll show you a close-up of that a little bit later. Probably still wondering what was going on with the rear hatch, and if you have done some of these in the past, you probably thought I was going to use one of these. Plumb bob. Again, with the DAS 3000 and the Hunter, we're going to simplify things. We're using the rear emblem along with the front emblem with the actual alignment laser to find our center line of the vehicle. Instead of going front, rear, and running a piece of tape, we're going to use our alignment laser to do that. But you'll see that we have to position it within the center of the front emblem, and then if you follow it all the way to the back, which may be difficult to see, but we'll show you a little bit of a close-up of trying to get it on that back emblem. That's why the hatch is open, because the emblem is raised enough where I can actually line it and get it to go through all the way across that roof of that vehicle. So I got it centered on the front, and it's on that back emblem as well, right through that center line of that vehicle. This is where it does get a little tricky though, because we still got to maintain our center line of the vehicle, but we also have to get our 3,000 millimeters from the front radar with our reflector. So it's kind of a balance act, as you'll see. But I'm going to turn my laser level or my distance tool on, and we're going to go ahead and see where we're at. And you're going to want to get it right on that emblem. You can see I have the actual laser right in the middle of that emblem there. And my distance is almost spot on. Again, that's only because I had the floor marked. I cheated a little bit, but I have done a few of these, so I know exactly where I kind of like to set things up when I do these. So we've got our distance there. Now we want to make sure that we have our center line still right through the emblems, just like we do there. So we've completed all of the steps right here for the front beam axis adjustment. We're going to go on to the next page and press continue. So the next thing it's going to have us do is make sure our stand is level. You have a bubble level down here, and actually on your distance laser, I have a level built right into it. And we'll get a close-up of that, and you'll be able to see that as well, so that I have this part, my horizontal and my vertical. All of this needs to be plumb. And if I'm looking down here, I am good right here. Again, I might have cheated a little bit. And I've also go ahead and leveled the actual stand right now, and I can look at my laser level, and it's telling me I'm good. So this is plumb. Everything is completely where it needs to be. So that means I can move on to the next step. After leveling, recheck your distance. My distance is still good. Make sure that you're still centered with the emblems there. All right, this is step 5 of 5. With the distance laser in the horizontal position, point the laser and adjust the height of the actual reflector that's here. Center it in that actual center of the emblem. To adjust the height of the reflector stand is simple as just loosening that knob and sliding it up and down to get it centered on the emblem. After we verify that our distance is good, everything's still good, I can remove the actual holder itself and the distance laser and set it off to the side. I'm not going to be using it anymore today. And we're going to press continue. Okay, so notice it says right here, ensure that nobody enters the area. You don't want anybody walking through in front of, obviously, when the radar turns on. Do not turn off the scan tool or the ignition switch. Do not move or shake the vehicle, and close all of the doors. Also, keep in mind, anything metal could affect this, so we're going to go ahead and move our stand that we've been using for our ADAS link out of the way as well, just so that the radar doesn't pick it up as well. So I'm going to slide that out of the way. And at this point, I am going to press continue. All right, warning, this radar transmit radio waves during calibration. Make sure there is a distance of at least 8 inches approximately between the radar and the body of any person. Press continue. And I have verified there's nobody over there. We're good. So calibration in progress. If you were able to pick up on that just a little bit, you might have heard the actual radar kick on. Sometimes you can hear it, sometimes you can't. This one I was able to actually hear that it came on when it was sending out and emitting its radio signals, basically aimed at that reflector. It's looking for it to come back. And we were able to hear that. And right now it says the beam axis adjustment was successfully completed, which is great. The next step is to ensure proper operation of the system. We have to do a front beam misalignment reading. And we're going to go ahead and follow that now. It takes us right through the next step. As long as that first one passed, it's going on to the next one. So we're going to continue. Again, same warnings. Nobody enter the area. Do not turn off scan tool. Close all of the doors, which, again, we're all good. So here is the front beam axis misalignment reading. It has the specifications for us listed there. If it's not within spec, we're going to have to do the beam axis adjustment again. Successfully completed. The next step is what it's going to do is if there was a 0.1 or a 0.2 reading, it's going to bring it all back to a zero and kind of give it a new zero reading. That's what this last step does. It's going to get rid of any of the offset. So we'll press continue. There's our offset specification, 0, 0. Calibration in progress, it's going to put it all back to zeros, and it is successfully completed. You'll also see I just generated a report for our customers to see as well that we do have E0 and E0 reading and has successfully been calibrated. And of course it tells us that it was successfully completed and we're back out. This radar is successfully completed, but with any other calibration that you do in the field, you always want to take it for a test drive to verify that the systems work as designed, everything is operational, and of course you do want to test it with a vehicle in front of you to verify that it will slow down and track the speed of the car in front of you. We're going to go out and take this for a test drive and we'll make sure that it is working. All right, we're going to go ahead and try out our system and make sure that it's operating as designed. Radar is ready to go. I'm going to press set. It is set to the desired speed. There is a car coming up ahead of us. We should start to slow down once the radar picks up the vehicle. And it has picked up the vehicle in front of us. We can verify that the system is operating as designed. We can safely return this vehicle back to the customer with full confidence that the system is working. Thanks again for watching. Join us next time and see what kind of vehicle and what calibration we'll be doing next, but I assure you it'll be something fun and something on ADAS. Thanks again.